This is part two of finding the circumference and area of a circle. In the first video, we came up with these formulas. The circumference is 2r times pi, and the area is r squared times pi. I actually didn't tell you why that's true, because you need to have some calculus. But for now, hopefully you will accept the formula. All right, so we're just going to go over some examples in this video. Remember, if you want the circumference, you're going to double the radius and multiply by pi. And for the area, you're going to square the radius and multiply by pi. Let's do this example. Find the exact circumference and area of a circle if its radius is 6 meters. Now, for meters, we could just write m. Okay? So let's do this. Circumference. What do? We double the radius. So that's going to be 12 times pi. And that's going to be 12 pi meters. Okay, that's the circumference. Let's do the area. How do we get the area? We square the radius. So we do 6 times 6, 36 pi meters. And that's all there is to it. I'm sorry, it's not meters, it's square meters. Because we're talking about area, meters times meters. Another way of writing square meters is just writing m squared. Okay, it's not a variable. The m in this case actually stands for meters. Okay, now let's approximate it. Let's use 3.14 for pi to get an approximation. Okay, it asked for the exact one, but let's say approximately how long that really is. So this is approximately 12 times 3.14 meters, which is 37.68 meters. Now, you can use your calculator or just do your multiplication for scratch work. All right, let's do the same thing for the area. Let's approximate it. So this is approximately 36 times 3.14 square meters, which actually equals 113.04 square meters. All right, so in green, I have the approximation, and in red, I have the exact answers. What does this mean? The circumference, if you went around the circle, that's the perimeter for the circumference, remember, it would be about, you know, between 37 and 38 meters around when you had a 6-foot diameter. And for the area, this means if you were going to tile it for, you know, something like that, or paint the floor, imagine that, that's about how many square meters you would have. Next problem. Find the exact circumference and area of a circle, of the circle shown below. I kind of had some extra sec. There we go, of the circle shown below. All right, so we're going to use the formula, but notice I've given you the diameter going all the way across. So the diameter of this circle is 8 inches, but then what then would be the radius? The radius is half of that, so it's 4 inches. Okay, so circumference, remember it's twice the radius, which is the diameter in this case, so it's going to be 8 pi. Now, we're talking about going around, so it's just inches. That's the exact answer. And the area, what do? We square the radius. So we have to do 4 times 4, that's 16 times pi, and this is going to be square inches. Square inches, or you can write that as 16 pi inches squared. Okay? And again, we can approximate the answer. These are the way you would write the exact answer for both the circumference and area. But if we're going to approximate it, we could say, well, 8 times 3.14, and for the area, we're going to do 16 times 3.14. So for the circumference, this actually equals 25.12 inches. That's the approximation, right? That's not the exact circumference. So going around, it's approximately 25 inches. Now let's approximate the area by doing 16 times 3.14, and that's going to be square inches. So that's going to give you 50.24 square inches. That's the approximate area of that circle. So we're just using the idea the circumference is double the radius times pi. The area is you square the radius times pi, and that's the exact answer. Then if you want to put in an approximation, you do so. 3.14 is a common approximation. You can also use the fraction 22/7, then you'd have a lot of fractions involved.